Welcome to tutorial number 3 of Introduction to Statistics Normal Distribution. Normal distribution is also called Gaussian distribution. Normal distribution is very popular, and the key question is why normal distribution is so popular. First of all, it's very compact. All data, if the distribution is normal, is distributed around the mean. 3 standard deviation to the left and to the right of the mean, pay attention to the horizontal axis. All data is captured between this 6 standard deviation from left to right. I will suggest to review tutorial 1 and tutorial 2 if the terminology of this tutorial is a little hard on you. This is the formula for normal distribution discovered by Gauss. It looks a little scary at the beginning, but imagine that I can justify that standard deviation can be 1 and x minus mu over sigma can be always. I can give a new name of this expression, which is deviation from the mean divided by the standard deviation. I can always call this z, and you know that z is very important. So normal distribution in which standard deviation is 1 and x minus mu over sigma is z is called z normal distribution or standard normal distributions. All scores, x scores, are standardized. And this is how the formula of standard normal distribution looks like. This is how I will put this formula in Excel. The constant E in this formula is equal to 0.7182, and this is an absolute constant that is very popular in mathematics and statistics and natural sciences. Normal distribution is always symmetrical. It represents the distribution of a random variable X, any random variable x. Normal distribution depends only on the mean and the standard deviation, and it changes as x changes. Normal distribution is symmetrical with respect to the mean. Normal distribution has its mode, median, and mean in the middle. Normal curve is simple and elegant, and normal distribution can be represented as a standard normal distribution by recalculating x values as z values. For this, we have to subtract from each x value the mean of the distribution, and if I have mu minus 3 sigma to be my x value, then minus mu, this would be negative 3 sigma, and negative 3 sigma divided by sigma will be exactly negative 3. Let's see how I can recalculate specific x values with Excel. Okay. I have here one example. Imagine that you have that you have a variable with mean 200 and standard deviation 50, and you want to calculate x value 3 standard deviation less than the mean. So it would be 200 plus this negative 3 times 50, which is the standard deviation. So my value, which is in this case 3 standard deviation to the left, is 50, and 3 standard deviation more than the mean would be 3 times 50 is 150 plus 200, 350. So let's say that I have these 3 important x values, which are x values starting with the mean and then adding and subtracting standard 1, 2, and 3 standard deviation from the mean. What are the z values of these specific x values? The z value actually is the x value, which is in front, 50, minus 200 in our case divided by 50, and you can recalculate for any mean and standard deviation. Ah, you see what is happening? The z value shows how many standard deviation from the mean is our x value measured in sigma. So if the x value is 3 standard deviation to the left of the mean, z value is negative 3. Now let's use the formula. I will show you how to calculate this formula. Here is the formula of Gauss distribution. Okay, and let's start calculating. This formula equals 1 divided by, and I will put parentheses, sqrt, which is square root of 2 times 3.14, close parentheses and close the denominator, times exponent, which is exponent with the base, this number e, which oftentimes is called Knepper or Euler number, 0.5, which is 1 second, negative, times the value of z. In my case, the value of z is negative 0.34, and it is recorded in cell B3 square to the power of 2. And I will close this parenthesis. And this is the probability that that a randomly selected person will have z value negative 3.4, a little bit more or less negative 3.4. And I will copy this formula to go from negative 3 to positive 3, because if you remember, normal distribution is for some reason I cannot move this. Okay. So, these are the probabilities. And now I took my z values a little bit clean without all z values, because it would be very hard on the figure. And I will control C and will copy all these as numbers. So this is the z value and the probability corresponding to these z values. And as you can see, this is the figure that I already have done. But let me take out this figure in order to show you how to do this figure with Excel. Okay. So I have z values, and z values can be... Okay, insert line. Let's grab this and put it on the top together with the formula to make sense. Okay. And I will move this a little bit also. We'll try to show you now how this normal distribution looks like. Okay, let's maximize. And this is the normal distribution from negative 3 to positive 3. You can see that this is a beautiful bell shape. Now, what else is important for normal distribution? Very important characteristic of normal distribution is that z values from negative 3 to positive 3 captured all the data. Also, we have from negative 1 to positive 1, almost 65% of all data is captured from negative 1 to positive 1, and almost 95% of all data is 2 standard deviation to the left, to the right of the distribution. And this is 1-2-3 rule that you, of course, should remember, but don't think that always the data is should be calculated like 1-2-3 standard deviation. This is just memorable feature of normal distribution. So why normal distribution is so popular? Is it easy to calculate? It is symmetrical, it is compact, and it has multiple real application. This is all for today. Thank you, and shall see you online.